Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 13, Fun with Magnets. And till our last class, we have finished with poles of a magnet. We were doing the last topic, that is poles of a magnet. What do we mean by poles of a magnet? Now, for that, for finding poles of a magnet, what we have done one activity. And in that activity, we have taken some of the iron fillings and we roll magnet into that iron fillings. When we roll magnet, we can take any kind of a magnet. We can take a bar magnet or simple magnet or donut magnet, whatever magnet we can take it. What we find it out? So here we have taken a bar magnet and what we find it out that maximum number of iron fillings were stick on the sides or on the poles. Now the region of a magnet where the attraction of magnet is strongest are called poles of the magnet. Now poles of the magnet is, there are two poles of a magnet, that is north pole and south pole. And if I'm going to divide this magnet into two part, and I'll be getting two more magnet, then again these two more magnet also have two poles, north pole, south pole, north pole, south pole. Again if I cut it in from in between, we will be getting four magnets. Again these four magnet have two poles, north pole, south pole, north pole, south pole, north pole, south pole, and then north pole, south pole. Again, if I am going to divide it into further, they are going to form 8 magnets having 2 poles each, that is north and south pole. So, what do we conclude from here? That if we will be having any kind of a magnet, it has 2 poles. Each magnet has 2 poles. 2 poles are there in each magnet. And that is for sure. Fine. Each magnet has 2 poles. One is north pole, other one is south pole. Now children, will come to next. That is poles of a magnet, like we have done that the region of a magnet where the attraction of magnet is the strongest are called poles of a magnet. Now a magnet has always 2 poles. That is, the 2 poles of a magnet are near its free ends. Now the 2 poles of a magnet are always different. One pole of a magnet is called north pole and the other one is called south pole. And in each magnet we have north pole as well as we have south poles. Now every magnet, whether is a big or small, it has north and south pole. Now next, which is very important, that like poles and unlike poles. Now each magnet has 2 poles. So what do we mean by like poles and unlike poles? Now here what I am going to do it. Here I am going to take another concept which is related to poles of a magnet only. That we can use a magnet to find out whether the soil or sand at a place is having any iron particle or not. So this small activity normally the children, they have done also. Then here what we are going to do it, we are going to take 2 magnets and we are going to keep these 2 magnets in front of it. Now what we find it out, that these 2 magnets are going to repel each other means they are not going to stick to each other. On the other side, I have taken 2 more magnets and what I find it out here, that these 2 magnets are going to attract each other. They are not going to repel each other, they are going to attract each other. Now what do you mean by this? Like two bar magnets we have taken, they are going to repel each other, and 2 bar magnet we have taken which are going to attract each other. Now what I have told you, that each magnet has 2 poles, so north pole
south pole. Here what happened? South pole, north pole. I can kept it in any way. But here what happened? North pole, south pole, north pole, south pole.
Do you understand here something? We have taken two magnets, but here south pole is there in front of south pole. And here south pole is there in front of north pole. So what do we conclude here? That each bar magnet has two poles, north pole and south pole, that we have already done. Each bar magnet or each any kind of a magnet, you can take it, it has two poles, that is north pole and south pole. But when I have kept bar magnet like this, that south pole is there in front of south pole, then what happened? They are going to repel each other. Since these are unlike poles, these are not like poles. Like poles or unlike poles? These are like poles or unlike poles. Like poles means same. So like poles, if same poles were there, they are going to repel each other. So we have here like poles. Like poles we have. So here also we have south, here also we have south. So what do we conclude from this first one? That like poles repel each other. If we are going to take two magnet, then what we conclude? That like poles repel each other. Whereas when we have unlike poles, like here we have taken south and here we have taken north. So unlike poles. What does unlike poles do? Unlike poles attract each other. Unlike poles attract each other. Got it? So the same type of a magnetic poles are called like poles. So here what is the important conclusion? That is important conclusion of these two, that is like poles repel each other if we have like poles. Now here I can, here you can take one more example. Like if I am taking two magnets, each magnet has north pole on this side, north, south, again north and south. So north and north, in the both magnet we have kept north pole in front of north pole. So same type of magnetic poles, that is like poles, these two are like poles. So what will be the first conclusion? That like poles repel each other. Now here each other means these two magnets are going to repel each other. Then second case is what? Like poles repel each other. But if I turned it, like here we have taken north-south. And here again we have taken north south. Unlike poles we have taken. Unlike poles we have taken. Now what do we find it out? Unlike poles. So conclusion will be unlike poles. Unlike poles attract each other. Unlike poles attract each other. These two conclusions regarding poles of a magnet is very important. These two conclusions regarding poles of magnet is very important. Like the same type of magnetic poles are called like poles. For example, a north pole and another is north pole. I have told you that. Now the different types of magnetic material are called unlike poles. Unlike poles attract each other, like poles repel each other. Then what do next? What is important? Poles of a magnet we have done. Then properties of magnet. Now there are two important properties of magnets which we are going to discuss next. All these things are very important. If you are watching video, you can pen down somewhere. Now properties of magnet. Properties of magnet. Till now we have done many things about magnets. We have done properties, like we have done magnetic material, how magnets were discovered, how
magnetic material differentiate from non-magnetic material? What is the difference between attraction and repulsion? Poles of a magnet also we have done. So now different types of magnet also we have done. Properties of magnet, let's see what are the properties of magnet. That is the two most important properties of magnet that only we are going to discuss first. First is a freely suspended magnet always point in the north and south direction. So that two most important properties of magnet are, number one, a freely suspended magnet always a freely suspended magnet always points in the north-south direction, So this I told you in the beginning only, that if you are going to tie a bar magnet and just hang it, what did you find it out? That magnet is going into rest only in north and south direction. So what we have done here, a freely suspended magnet always points in the north and south direction. Number two, like magnets pole repel each other. And unlike these two important properties of magnet is there. Number two, like magnetic poles repel each other, comma, unlike magnetic poles, attract each other. So what we have done, properties of magnet, two important properties of magnet that we have seen just now. Number one, a freely suspended magnet always points in the north-south direction. Number two, like magnetic poles repel each other, and unlike magnetic poles attract each other. Now let's see or understand these two properties. Now what is the use of this first property? If I'm going to discuss this first property, a freely suspended magnet always point in north and south direction. So what is the use of it? Now one activity we can do it. You can take a bar magnet, tied it with a thread and hang it and leave it. What did you find it out? That bar magnet is suspending, and the bar magnet which is suspending is pointing toward north and south direction. Its north pole is seeking north direction, as well as south pole is seeking to the south direction. Now what is the use and how this property of magnet make it more useful? Now this property of magnet help to find directions. Sailors, the people like those who are fishermen, those who are going to catch fishes in the oceans, they won't be able to forget the way. They were using this compass. In compass, this magnet is placed just below that, the needle which is painted in north and south direction, and red and green direction, and red and blue. And then due to a magnet, since magnet is going to end in
or once it is freely suspended, so freely suspended will be available in that compass, and then it is showing directions in north. If we will be able to know north and south direction, we can calculate the rest two direction, and then we can do accordingly. Now the sun always rises in the morning in the east direction. Again, you can take that compass and stand, and then you can find it out. Now, finding directions, the property of a freely suspended magnet to align itself always along the north-south of the earth is used to find direction at unknown places. So this freely suspended magnet or a freely pivoted magnet always comes to rest along the north-south direction. Now it is not useful in a case of like forest, if somebody is going to forward its way in forest, they won't be able to find the direction in that forest. Now here I just talk about compass. Now compass is what? Compass is an instrument which is used to find the directions at a place. Now compass help the people to find their way. For example, soldiers in jungle to find their movement. Compass is used by sailors, which is going in sea. Why? So here, one important question arises that why a freely suspended magnet or freely pivoted magnet always point in the same direction, north-south direction? Actually, our planet Earth is always also shows magnetism. Now, Earth behaves as if a giant bar magnet is buried at its center. So, it is the force exerted by the Earth, imaginary magnet, which acts as a freely suspended bar magnet or freely pivoted magnetic needle of a compass, and makes them always point in the north and south direction. So attraction and repulsion, again, that like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other. Repulsion and attraction properties, which is your second property of magnet. Just now we have done this also, that like poles means if two bar magnet we have, and both the bar magnet will be kept in such a way that each is pointing toward the same pole of other, then they are going to repel. Means repulsion force, you can find it out in between. But on the other hand, if you are going to change the direction of that magnet, and you will get unlike poles in front of it, like north pole will be there in front of north pole, so they are going to attract each other. So attraction and repulsion between magnet is also again an important property, and that only is going to conclude this, like magnetic poles repel each other and unlike magnetic poles attract each other. Now poles of a magnet plays an important role when you are using magnet. How they attract to each other, how they repel to each other, all these things are very important. Now, activity to test for a magnet, how we can test it? We can take identical bars of iron. So, this activity to test magnet, that we are going to take it in our next class. And even we can make our own magnet also. We can take a metal piece and then we can make our own magnet. So these two properties, like properties of magnet, a freely suspended magnet always point in the north and south direction. Number two, like magnetic poles repel each other and unlike magnetic poles attract each other. So that will be there. So in the next class we are going to take the next topic, that is related to this, how to make your own magnet, then magnetic poles we have finished, and precautions while handling, and what
precautions you should take and how to store a magnet. So that also we are going to see in the next class. There we'll be finishing the class here. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.